ladies and gentlemen, you have a choice. Very good Russian language or very bad English. What will be choice? Come on. Russian, yeah? Okay, so in that occasion, you have to forgive my bad English. Anyway, I'm very proud to be here. Thank you very much for your invitation. And today we will speak about start of the Second World War. Just 70 years ago, 1st of September 1939, Germany attacked Poland. 3 days later, Great Britain and France declare war for Germany. So 1st of September, 70 years ago, it is the start of the Second World War. And I like to show you something. Maybe everybody just always see it's the official coat of arm of Soviet Union. And in that picture, there is something very, very strange. The strange thing, it is a coat of arm, official symbol of Soviet Union, but in that official symbol, there is no Soviet Union at all. Where is Soviet Union? Come on. You see, so there is an earth, and there is a symbol of communism over earth. Yeah? Can you imagine if Adolf Hitler, somewhere in 1933 or 34, 45, something, he just put earth and swastika over it, you see, and say, that is our national symbol. It would be a little bit strange. And I think everybody would protest, they say, come on. But when Soviet Union just used such a thing for 70 years in Washington, it was a Soviet embassy. You see, it was such a thing. Nobody protest, they say, we like to capture the whole world. And you say, it's okay, yes, nobody protest, it's okay. So, it is a comrade Stalin, actually, it is a Soviet leader when the Second World War started. It's a very good picture because it's a picture made in police. It's a police picture because that guy, he have a very good profession. His profession is bank robbery. Yeah, really. So he escaped out of prison 7 times. It was a very smart guy, you see. So, and later he became leader of the Soviet Union. It is quite a guy, and one of the greatest politicians of America, Ronald Reagan, called Soviet Union evil empire. And I completely agree with that, evil empire. If it's a bank robber on the top of a great state, you see, you can imagine, it has to be. Only Ronald Reagan, he mean evil empire in the 70s. But what I like to say to you, it was even evil empire in the 20s, in the 30s, in the 40s, and so on, and so on. So, Second World War started. Yes, it is Comrade Stalin and Comrade Hitler. Now you know Hitler start the Second World War, and he is a guilty guy, yes, as guilty as devil, yes. I agree with that, but please, let's pay attention. Stalin have a half military uniform, Hitler have a half military uniform, without any kind of epaulet. They both don't like big decoration, you see, so two good guys. In a Stalin Russia, one party in a ruling country, all other parties in a concentration camp, just like in Germany, yes? Stalin have a gulag, Hitler have a Svensim, so Stalin have a NKVD, that guy have a Gestapo, so that guy killed people by millions, and that guy killed people by millions. Stalin have no beard at all, yeah? And Hitler have no beard at all. Stalin have a mustache, and Hitler have a mustache. And once I just think, you see, so it have to be difference between them. Yeah, it have to be difference. And actually, I did find that difference. Difference is in the shape of mustache, you see, so. Because Hitler have a like that, and Stalin, you see, so. What is the Soviet Union and Germany? They divided Poland. Actually, I will just told about, it was a marvelous story, but please look at that picture. It is a Stalin and Hitler, they sign agreement. You see, half Poland for you, half Poland for me. Hitler attack after Stalin attack Poland. Yes. So, but both in a, it is a cartoon of that time, 1939. Whole world understand it's two criminals, both have knives, you see, they smile to each other, they're friends, but, you see, so anytime. Now we know Hitler attacked Stalin, so it's bad guy. But in that time, nobody knows how it will happen. So, please look that. It is a General Guderian, it is a Cambrich brigade commander Krivosheyev, and look his arms, you see, so maybe he keep a knife, you see, maybe axe, look, look him, and look that guy, yes, it is exact, I don't know what he holding, look, it's exactly the same, look, isn't it? Now, as you know, Soviet Union finished Second World War as a liberator of Europe. You see, so it is a great monument in Berlin. It's a Russian soldiers with destroying swastika and saving young girl. It is such a great symbol of victory of against the evil. And it is a Russian liberator in a Germany. He just takes some trophy, you see, for memory. That is a red flag over Berlin. It is a Reichstag. You see, and there is the two guys here. One put hammer and sickle. And I pay attention for, because actually, my profession, I'm an intelligence officer. Lots of time ago, I realized it is an evil empire. I say bye-bye for that evil empire. So I have a couple death sentences, you see. So, but my profession, just to pay attention to small details. And small details here, it's one guy here put that, and I just look that one. You see, I just make bigger picture. So, and look that, because it's such a historical moment. You see, so they just put red flag over Berlin. That guy have a watch here and have a here, you see, so. Look that, just to be sure, you see, so that is a moment. It is very strange for me because actually why two watches? Generally, Russian soldiers, they have a 2, 3, 4, 5 here, and here, you see, only two. It's a very modest liberator. End of the Second World War, and it's American and Russian met each other in a river called Elba. You see, they kiss each other. It's a friends. They have some drink, you see, so they like, yes, it is the finish of the Second World War. In a river Elba, yes, it's Russian and Americans, you see, so. But start of the Second World War, it was a meeting of two armies in a different river. It was a river called Bug, you see, so. That is a Russian, you see, and somebody else, they are kissing each other. You see, it is a, isn't it strange, yeah? Finish of the war, we are brother with American, but start of the war, we are brother with Nazis, yeah? The world forgot about that situation, you see, so it is a NKVD, it is a guy from German army. Look them. Look them, it's brothers in arm. It is a Russian BT-7 tank, it's a Germans, you see, hi, boy, we just destroyed Poland. Yes, I salute you, yeah? Look, it is a Russian, it's a German all around, it is a Russian German behind them. Yes, it is the same brotherhood, so it's a Russian say, what is the way to Central City? German say, straight on and left, please, you see? So it is a Russian armored personal armored cars, you see, and German among them, some drinking, something, you see, so Russian and German, yes, my brothers, yes, yes. It is a parade in Brest, 22nd of September 1939, when fortress in Brest was defended by Polish army, heroical defense. After that, German captured it, the Russian come in, and there is a parade. There is a German motorbike and Russian tank. It is T-26. So after German flag down, you see a Russian up, you see a Russian and German. Yes, it is a Russian T-26. It's a German vehicles. Yes, it's a 26 T-26, and it's a Germans. Yes, it's a parade. You see brothers in arm. Yes. Yes, and how it's happened? What's actually happened in August of 1939? Where is a Stalin, and where is a Hitler, and between them where is a neutral Poland? Poland between them. So, meaning I cannot attack you, you cannot attack me. Where is a Poland between us? So. If Stalin don't like to fight, if Hitler don't like to fight, we have to always just keep that neutral territory. Just say, come on, Adolf Hitler, if you attack Poland, you see, so I will fight against you. Adolf Hitler say, look, there is one city, Danzig, it's a German city. Actually, he's right. It's a German city, but according to Versailles Treaty, it's an independent city. And there is Maine. Germany and Eastern Prussia, according to Versailles Treaty, they've been separated. Adolf Hitler say, I need motorway from Germany to Eastern Prussia, and Danzig have to be German city. Stalin say, come on, why you need it? It's such a small thing. Why not? Half Poland for you, half for me. Yeah? Isn't it? It's good, yeah? So, and they will attack, you see, so, please, can you send your guy, you see, Mr. Ribbentrop, what is a Ribbentrop? It's a Minister of Foreign Affairs of Germany. He say, please come here, and we will divide Poland. Please, can you imagine, America have no Iran as a neighbor. Do you need Iran as a neighbor? It would be terrible, yeah? So, Soviet Union have no Germany as a neighbor. And Stalin give proposition, why not divide Poland and it will be common border between us, yeah? You're just bad guy, I'm sorry, can you imagine for 2 minutes you are, yes, Adolf, yes, and I'm comrade Stalin, yes? And I say, look, it will be common border. In that case, you can attack me, yes? It's very bad. But what is my reason to have a common border with you, my dear friend? Yeah? Why? So anyway, Ribbentrop come to Moscow very quickly, in the same day, 23rd of August, they divided Poland into two, half for you, half for me. And say, in 1 week we will attack. In 1 week. Agree, yes? So, today it's the 23rd of August, 1st of September, we will attack. You, Adolf Hitler, sorry, yes. You attack 1st of September, you attack Poland, yes? And I say, I'm not ready. Isn't it fantastic? It's, please imagine, we try, you and me, we try to kill somebody. Yeah, why not? Yes, yeah, so just, one, two, three, you see, so just, one, two, three, you say, bam! And I say, no ammunition, sorry, yeah? Who is bad guy, yes? Who start, who killed innocent person? Yeah? Who is innocent? It's me, yeah? It's actually what's happened in August of 1939. Stalin say for Hitler, yes, please, half Poland for you, half for me, please. We will attack 1st of September, okay? You attack, and I say, sorry, I'm not ready, yeah? Who is bad guy? Yes, yes. So, after 3 days, Great Britain and France declare war for Adolf Hitler, yeah? But be kind, you cannot win such thing, because Germany have no such a navy like a Britain, yeah? You cannot destroy Great Britain. You have no strategic aviation. just 3rd of September, he was in a very, very bad situation. But behind Great Britain, there is a big country, you see, behind all this. It's called the United States of... Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So, 3rd of September, Adolf Hitler lost Second World War completely. And Stalin waiting, I'm not ready, yeah? So, Hitler destroyed all Polish army. After 17th of September, Stalin say, oh yes, now I'm ready, yes, okay, yes. And half Poland for me, half for you, okay? Yes. But you're a bad guy. You start Second World War, yeah? I'm not. We divided, please. Remember forever. Pact to start Second World War was signed not in Berlin, but in Moscow. Isn't it strange? And it was no Adolf Hitler here, it was Comrade Stalin here, yeah? So, if Stalin is a decent person, he have to say, Adolf, I'm not ready. 1st of September, let's divide Poland, let's do it, yeah? But I am not ready 1st of September, please. Let's attack 1st of November, 1st of December. Next year, Poland between us, Poland will never escape, you see, so you need half of Poland, I need half of Poland, let's do it next year, yeah? But he say, 1st of September, Hitler attack, I am not ready, that's all. So, it is a Ribbentrop signing, you see, it's a Comrade Stalin behind, very happy, yes, and there is a division of, it is a Poland, it's a Ribbentrop signature, and Comrade Stalin start to sign here, Iosif Sta. Suddenly he stop, and he just, Stalin, wow, wow, 58 centimeter. Do you know what is a 58 centimeter? No. Of course you don't. I will show you. What is a 58 centimeter, yeah? 40, yes, 50, 58, look at that, yeah? You believe me, yeah? 58, yeah? 58, yeah? Come on, it is something. I'm not psychologist. I'm not psychologist at all. I'm simple Russian spy, you see, but... But even so, you see, so, even simple Russian spy can understand. Comrade Stalin is a very, very, it's a top excitement, yeah? Can you imagine he start like this, stop, wow, you see, hello, yes. Why? Number one, because it's a trap. I explain you, it's a trap. Half Poland for you, half for me. You will attack, I'm not. So, and number two, that signature, that one, it's completely illegal. It's illegal. Because that is guy, Ribbentrop. Ribbentrop, it's a minister of foreign affairs of Third Reich. Yes? Yes. He is a foreign minister. He have a right to sign some very important documents. But Stalin, he is not president. He is not prime minister, he is not minister, he is not member. He is a general secretary of party, yeah? Let's imagine if somebody now divide Iran or Iraq or something in a two, and the boss of Democratic Party will sign it. You see, so. It's rubbish, yeah? It's a no illegal legal significance at all, because Stalin have no official duty at all in that time. Later he became, in 41, he became prime minister. In war he was supreme command-in-chief and so on and so on. But in 39, he was a general secretary of Communist Party, nothing else. Только вождь. But it's not official, yeah, vождь, what is vождь? It's a leader, you see, so our great, and so what? we divided, so it is a Russian and German officer just made some kind of details. It will be border between us, you see, so it is a one, border. It is a Russian, it is a German, you see, so we will be good friends forever. But it's American cartoon of that time. Now you can say I'm stupid, I'm bad, yes, I am, but in that time, American people can see situation in a very different way. There is a Poland, here Poland, and there is an explosive, and there is a two bad guys who like to blow up Europe. Actually, as I explained, one of that guy was a smart guy, you see, and second was a little bit naive. It is Russian and Germans in Poland. Germany destroyed Polish army, but flower of victory for Red Army, yeah? So just half for you, half for me, you see, so I'm innocent, I protect just Poland, that's all, you see, so, and you aggressor. American cartoon of that time, you see, so it is a Poland, and it is actually two guilty, it's a Nazi and Soviet Union, you see. Now we don't forgot the role of the Soviet Union, it's a way dividing. In Brest, Germans give to Red Army, it is a Russian commissar, it is a Polish soldiers, you see, so it's a German all around. You see, they give to Russian all captured prisoners, you see, as a present, goodwill for Russian. All officers being killed later by Stalin, NKVD. 10,000 Polish officers, you see, so just. Yes. Strange thing, all Polish officers who been captured by German and in German concentration camp, generally they survive. Somebody died because of wounded, because of disease, and so on. But all Polish officers been captured by Red Army, you see, soldiers, they all been killed, generally. The point is, it is Comrade Ежов Николай Иванович, Chief of Russian Secret Police, 1937-38, Николай Иванович Ежов. And Comrade Stalin like him very much, Ежов and Stalin. So Stalin say for Ежов, there is a lots of enemy of people, my personal enemy. Can you kill all of them? Ежов say, sir, please, this is so big terror. He just destroying tens of thousands of people, you see, who can be enemy of Stalin, or potential enemy, or presumably potential enemy, he killed of them. After Stalin say, wow, you're a madman, you see, he killed Ежов. And, yeah, and who is guilty? Of course Ежов is guilty. Stalin never killed people himself, you see. Stalin is a smart guy. And actually, that period of Soviet history, it's Ежовщина, yeah? It's not Сталинщина. It's Ежов, bad guy, yeah? So, and then killed him in early 39, and exactly same pattern of Stalin behavior, but only not inside of Soviet Union, but outside. So, Hitler, can you destroy Europe? Yeah, can you do it? I will help you. So, you need oil? Yes, I will give you oil. You see, I just show you the simplest possible instrument. Simplest, simplest possible. And here it's a chrome and vanadium. It's just written here. You can read it, yeah? Okay, everybody believe. Chrome and vanadium. Without chrome and vanadium, you cannot build submarines, cruiser, tanks, guns, and so on and so on. Germany have no chrome, no vanadium, no oil, no food. Okay, Stalin say, I will supply you, yeah? Please don't worry. Don't worry. Can you destroy Europe? In a Stalin strategy, he called, non-officially, he called Adolf Hitler icebreaker. Icebreaker of revolution. Adolf Hitler, please, you see, so please destroy France, Belgium, Holland, Norway, Yugoslavia, you see, so I will be behind you, I will supply you, don't worry, please, come forward, forward, forward. After that, it would be like with Mr. Ежов, you're a bad guy, I destroy you, and so on. Let's imagine situation. spring of 1941, in Europe, Hitler destroyed, in a continental Europe, all the states, all the government, all political parties, all trade unions, all armies, whole Europe, yeah? And he is ready to come forward to attack Great Britain, yes? And if he attacked Great Britain, so all his navy would be mainly against Great Britain, aviation against Great Britain, army against Great Britain, all his tanks, all his best general, and so on. And behind him, there is a comrade Stalin as a liberator, and whole Europe waiting for that liberation with two watches, yeah? In that time, Europe just waiting for liberation. So, it is a Nikita Khrushchev, it is a Russian dictator who became a dictator after Stalin. And it's the 29th of September, 1939, and I find exactly what he say in that Nikita Khrushchev, it is a Russian dictator who became a dictator after Stalin. And it's the 29th of September, 1939, and I find exactly what he say in that particular time. In my book, there is that documents and so on. He just, in that moment, he said, so Germans were just behind in that side of river, and he just came here and he said, let German made all the crimes. We will liberate Europe later. More crimes we create, it's better for us, yeah? Because all Europe will ask for a liberation. Yes, it is a Russian oil for Germany. When we just looking history, Battle of Britain, there is Spitfire and Messerschmitt. Wow, wow, wow. Spitfire and Messerschmitt. And I always say, please, there is three actually persons here. Spitfire, Messerschmitt, and Russian oil. Without Russian oil, nothing will happen. Battle in Atlantic, you see, so there is a Tirpitz, Scharnhorst, Gneisenau, German submarines, I say, and Russian oil, yeah? Without Russian oil, so why comrade Stalin just supply Hitler? If he say no oil, no aluminum, no, not food, you see, so the war will stop immediately. Anyway, comrade Stalin, yes, that is a situation. It's a British cartoon of 1941. Adolf Hitler prepared attack of Great Britain. He just planning. Look the situation. Yeah, I like that situation. Look that, yeah? And comrade Stalin behind say, please do it, yeah? Why not? And somebody can say, but Red Army was not ready for a war. Yes. And all of you, you just read hundreds of books. Red Army, don't ready for a war. I say, stop. Not ready for defense. It's a different thing. Not ready for a war and not ready for defense. Ready for a war. Readiness. Please, let's look last day of the war. May of 1945. And please give me answer who is ready, who is not. Adolf Hitler commits suicide. He is ready for a war. Come on. Of course, Russians have a very bad start, and I explain why very bad. Because if I prepare to attack you, so just I'm exposed myself. And in that time, you see, so Adolf Hitler just so boom, like that, you see, oh. And it's a why. I'm sorry, ladies, you see, so I'm very rude guy, but I'll try to explain my ideas. The point is, when you prepared for an offensive war, you have a different kind of equipment. For example, it is a T-40. Only one country in the whole world have an amphibious tank in that time, and it's the Soviet Union, T-40. Not Germany, not America have no amphibious tank in that time. But in an offensive war, you need them, you have to cross the rivers. In a defensive war, you just withdrawing your troops and blow up the bridges. You don't need amphibious tanks, yeah? So best amphibious tank, T-40. It is a T-37, that is a T-38. They just carry them, you see, so on the aircraft, you see, across the front line and drop like that. It is a quite technology, you see, so look that, like, whoop, yeah, look that. So when its amphibious come forward, in defensive, when Hitler attack, we have to protect our country. We don't need all that technology at all. We don't need amphibious tank. We abandoned them. Look that. It is BT-7. It's a beautiful machine. What is good about that? It can drop trucks, you see, so, and in a motorway, it's 100 kilometers, 70 miles, yeah? In a motorways, whap. But Russia have no motorways now, yeah? Why you need motorway tanks if you have no motorway? But Germany have. So they in a truck, they fighting in our territory a little bit, you see, so when they come to motorways, you see, so they drop the trucks and come forward. Yes, if there is a blow up bridges, it is so powerful, it can jump over bridges, you see, over river. Nobody have such a technology now. Look that, it's T-34. It's the best tank of Second World War, and actually it's the best tank of all time. German captures them, and the best German division use T-34. Yes, look, it is a German tank. We have two best tank, Panzer II and Panzer IV. It's Panzer III. The gun, what is it? See, it is so strange. Look that. Look that. It is a 6-inch gun, yeah? 6-inch, 152. Nobody now, no one country, including Russia, have such guns on their tanks. But that tank you cannot use in defensive war because it's quite slow, you see, so very big shell, enormous shell. Why we have such tanks? If you have a fortification in front of you, you have to have a very big shell, just destroy fortification. Actually, we use it in Mannerheim line in the Winter War, 1939-1940. It was very successful. When Germans attack, you don't need such a tank at all. So, please come in. It's the best German tank, PC-3. Please look the gun. Please look that. It's quite different, yeah? Look. What is the best German self-propelled gun of 1941? It's near Moscow. Pay attention how short the barrel. You see, it's a caliber 75 millimeter, but barrel is so short. Look that, yeah? Isn't it? Now, it is abandoned Russian tank and it is a German anti-tank shell. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. It's only in that small place, yeah? So we cannot penetrate it. So, and Russians say, we are not ready for a war. I say, look that. That is a KV, and actually it is from behind. Look, and it's a very big shell here. You see, so, and we cannot penetrate it. Nobody in the world have a tanks like that in 1941. It's a German tank, you see, so if there is something, it's destroyed immediately. So if there is something shell, more or less big one. Before, it's a Russian howitzer, you see, so each shell 100 kilograms. So it's very good to fight, yes, that one, that one. If you're fighting in a Königsberg, if you're fighting in Berlin, yes, you need such a thing. You see, so there is lots of buildings in front of you, you put like that. And, but in a defensive war, you cannot turn it left and right. It's too heavy, 17 ton. So it's the best in the world, you see, so for a street, yes, nothing better. But in 1941, what we have to do, to put some sand inside of barrel, or is one shell, press a button, you see, so, and that howitzer destroys itself. In defensive war, we don't need it. So some of Russian airfields, now they say it's a bad aircraft and so on and so on. Some Russian airfields was 2 kilometers near German border, 2 kilometers. But airfield Высокая near Brest, 800 meters to border. Yes. So if you come up, you over German territory immediately. But if Germans attack, they use just sniper or just ordinary rifle, just killing Russian pilot, you see, so. So if you're for offense, if you prepared yourself for offense, it's a right position for your airfields. Your army come forward, you have to support them, they come forward, you have to support them. But if they attack you, you see, so what is happened with Russian aviation? Germany have 3,000 aircraft, Russian have 21,000 aircraft, you see, so. And now they say it was a bad one. But even it's a MiG-29, you see, 800 meters near the border. What you will do? You will lose them immediately. Motherland called you. It's a very famous slogan of before the war. You see, so, but I have to pay for attention, and it's, say, 15th of March 1941. When Hitler attacked, you see, everywhere Mother Russia called you, yes? But they published it 2 months before German attack, yeah? How we know? And Stalin never know, you see, so Stalin don't believe when Hitler attacked. He was very surprised. You see, so, but everything was prepared. And look that. Кратко русско-немецкий военный разговорник для бойца. So the short Russian-German phrasebook for soldiers. It is published. It's published 29th of May 1941. Wow. Wow. You see, so why if we don't waiting for a German attack? So, but immediately, it was a Moscow print. Immediately, it is the 5th of June 1941, it's a Leningrad. So they start to publish it in Odessa, in Kiev, in Minsk, in Riga, 6 million of them. So every soldiers you see have a here in the boots, you see, so you just open it and just for example, захват железнодорожной станции разъезда. Как называется эта станция? In a German, we heiste diese Station, and in a German, by the German, stop, stop. If it is a great patriotic war, and we're fighting for our homeland, you and me, we come in into some village, you see, and say, we heiste, come on, we say, this is Smolensk, we're in Russian territory. So, oh, for example, here, прекрати передачу, иначе застрелю. So it is just, please stop sending your telegram, I will shoot you. Yeah, so just, actually, I just find exactly same phrase book German use, you see, so, and I think, come on, come on, come on, come on. It's have to be difference. It's have to be difference between Russian and German. And I try to find difference. Exactly same thing, we say, what is the name of that, you see, so just, I think it's have to be. One night I don't sleep, second night, and suddenly I say, oh yes, I got it, I got it. Sometimes Germans say, bitte, you see, so Russian never say that. You see, please, they say German. Вам нечего бояться, here it's just, вам нечего бояться, скоро придет Красная Армия. Sie brauchen keine Angst zu haben, bald kommt die Rote Armee. Please don't worry, Red Army will be soon here. Yeah? Isn't it? Somebody say, where is document? I say, what is the document? Yeah? Isn't it? Скоро придет Красная Армия. Sie brauchen keine Angst zu haben, bald kommt die Rote Armee. Please don't worry, Red Army will be soon here. Yeah? Isn't it? Somebody say, where is document? I say, what is the document? Yeah? Isn't it? So 6 million of such a document. It is American tanks actually, and I show in an American example. When you prepared for a defense, you spread your power, you see, so. And to destroy one tank from air, it's not possible, because you have to spot it, it is under camouflage, you see, so, and to find it, and to just, but if you prepared for offense, you are very, very vulnerable. If one diving bomber will be here, it would be a terrible disaster. You agree? Because, look, it is a tanks, 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 and what is it? It's definitely ammunition and fuel here. And it's such easy targets, yes, one bomb, bam, and that's all. So, but in 1944, of course, American army don't worry because it's a total superiority in air, you see, so nobody worry. But it's what's happened with Red Army. They staying by masses on a border. And Germany attack, one bomb, and that's all. It is a Russian soldiers, you see, so surrender, but he is in a prison uniform. In May of 1941, Stalin take 1 million Russian prisoners from Gulag, he give weapon to them and put forward. Can you imagine if Comrade Putin now will take 1 million people from a prison, give them Kalashnikov and move to border of somebody? Yeah? Of course, you say, what is the value of such a soldiers? Yeah? No value at all, no. And Stalin explained value of that kind of soldiers. It is a second strategic echelon prisoners. First strategic echelon, it is a professional army. And he explained, there is a campfire, and if there is a good fire, it is a doesn't matter what is the logs, it's a good or bad, you see, very wet, doesn't matter, good fire, it's okay. If we are offensive and we successful, wet guys, they're angry, they're hungry, you see, so you put them in Europe, you say, where is a bicycle, where is a watches, you see, so come on, guys, you see. It would be okay. But because Hitler attacked first, and he destroyed first strategic echelon, second strategic echelon surrender, it's a prisoners. It is a slaves. It is a Germany prepared for a blitzkrieg. Did you ever see Hollywood film and German on the horses? Ever, please. Please. Never. Never. But we have 3,000 tanks and 750,000 horses. 750, 750,000 horses. Blitzkrieg. Now we're just clever and so on, but everybody just try to forget what kind of army it was. Because I'm a spy, I always pay attention for small details, and I pay attention to backside of that officer, and it's a shiny. Don't smile, because it is a leather, because it's a cavalry officer, yeah? And it is a Russian BR-10, it is a wonderful armored car. You see, it is a 45 millimeter gun. In 39, no one German tank have such a big gun. You see, even in 41, you see, it was a quite good gun which can destroy any German tanks. And German cavalry, because Russian abandoned all their weapons, you see, so now German cavalry have an opportunity to use modern equipment of 20th century. It is a German with a Russian PPSH. That is a German in Africa, that is a German, but that is a PPSH, because even what we captured in Russia was enough to supply the army in Germany. That is a T-34, best tank in the world, in a German service, Russian tank. It's T-34. It is a T-34 behind. What is it? It's 34. That is German aircraft. It's German. Look that, you see, so. It's maybe it's a horse, it's some kind of cavalry. Look that, yeah? Now, everybody like to show how powerful German are. You see, so because German, they lost the war, and now they say, yes, we lost the war, but they are still clever guys. Communist, Russian communist, they like to show, yes, we've been so powerful, and they're so weak. Why? Why we just saying that? It's like in a prison, in a courtroom. You see, half of American film, it's objection, Your Honor, yeah? So, there is a guy, you see, so, he's a murderer. And he always tried to present himself, oh, I'm so stupid, oh, I cannot create such a clever plan, you see, so, who tried to present himself as an idiot, it's a, generally, it's a criminal who tried to hide his criminal deed. So it's what's happened with Soviet Union. We have to explain what's happened in 1941. What's happened, I explain to you. We've been prepared for attack. Because we're prepared for attack, we're not prepared for defense. That's all. We have to hide it. And we explain, oh, German aircraft, we all been super modern and so on. Oh, German tank, we're best in the world. Yes, it is a German tank in Russia. And when German lost Second World War, they explain the reason why. They say it's a vast country. It's an enormous country, yes? They say there is a frost, there is no roads. Yeah? That is the reason why. They are clever guys, you see, so. For that, there is my simple answer. I say, stop, boys. Before to attack Russia, you have to send one super spy to Russia, and he have to send you top secret information. Russia is a big country, actually, yes? And according to that information, you have to prepare yourself for a fight, yes? We have to say, there is some frost sometimes in Russia, yes? Russian road, you see, so it's not American motorway. Please, be ready. You see? So, I can speak non-stop, but our time nearly finished. And what I like to say to you, you're so lucky people. Because for you, your country, your people, your government, your constitution, your president, you see, so it's the same thing. You're loyal to your people, to your country, to your president, to your government. You see, so it is a... I am unlucky guy, because for me it is a country, it is a one. My people, it is a one thing. And criminal regime, it's a little bit different. And to be, you cannot be loyal to your people and regime who destroy that people. That regime killed tens of millions of people. We are not idiots, you see, so just, we can launch first dog in a space. It's a Russian dog, yeah? Laika, yes, first woman in space, it's a Russian girl, yes, so first man in space is Gagarin. We can play chess, you see, so we're not idiots, yeah? So we produce more oil than anybody else, more than Saudi Arabia now. Lots of gas, diamonds, uranium, everything, and still, there is something wrong with that country. I'm here not because I hate my country. I'm here because I love my country. And I understand we cannot be loyal to that criminals, you see. We cannot be. We have to fight against that. Of course, maybe we will lose that fight. But still, Ronald Reagan say it is an evil empire. And it's still very dangerous empire. Because before it was a big power, all nuclear weapon under United control. Now we don't know who control it. Tomorrow, when Russia will split, but she will split, yes. We don't know who will control all of that. So, liberty, it is a golden key for any success. And you have a liberty. And your future job, present job, to protect liberty of United States of America. And I wish you good luck. I wish you success. And God bless America, of course. Thank you very much.